Prepare for battle.
All right. That should probably fix the deal. That should probably fix the deal now, as we're going to jump right into this game. This is the sixth game of the night, and this is the NA Dota Elite League coverage. I am your host, Ganks for Dota. And Arteezy is going to be playing the Lina this time around. So I was searching for what hero he's going to be playing after I saw PPD pick the Bloodseeker. So it's going to be a Lina, and looks like it's going to be a core Lina, as he was pooled some tangos. I Annihilate will handle the Centaur Warrunner. PPD will handle, looks like, a support Bloodseeker. This is something that I have not seen before. I've heard some theory crafting to do this, but
30 seconds to battle.
I don't know how successful this is going to be. This might turn into disaster. We'll definitely see. But let's finish up the lineup. Fear is going to handle our carry Lycan. And was I missing anyone? Crit's going to handle our Dazzle. Okay, so Crit denied his wisp once again for the second game in a row. It looks like it's going to be our
TZ. The battle begins.
Okay, so that's how it's going to work. Arteezy is going to be in the mid lane. He just wanted the rune, and then Crit, I guess he wasn't there to creep block, so the wave will be pushed away of SF. Somali will be very happy to have lane control over. Back to pushes all the way to the tower, so that benefits Arteezy a little bit more. Not able to block enough. Somali will find safe farm under his tower, at least for the first wave. But not able to get quite to level 2 yet, but Shadow Fiend's not a hero that needs his level 2 immediately. Safe. And it's Arteezy versus Arteezy 2.0. We're gonna keep an eye on this matchup. I'm just gonna keep my camera here. There, I do see some action going on elsewhere, and Yawar is gonna be playing on that Sand King along with Zai on the Wisp, facing the defensive tri lane. It looks like the Centaur is gonna be left bottom alone versus a Razor. That is definitely not a favorable matchup for him. Trout is going to be more the support role on the techies, just pulling. That's how he's going to be able to get his levels, and looks like Arteezy gets destroyed in the mid lane by the mines that were right there. Oh no. Absolutely baited. I missed the back end of that. I was wondering how he died. I should have kept my eye on that. I'm missing kills all over the place. It's top lane. Crit goes down to Dazzle. Now Fear is in trouble taking a tumble as well. Heal is going to come out. Crit is not quite level 2, so he doesn't have Grave available. He needs one more hit to finish off Zai, who buys a TP. TP's into with tethers into the lane. He will go down though. PPD looks like he's just doing some jungle. Bloodseeker or something along the lines of that. But Trout is behind with a double damage rune. Arteezy does miss the stun. And Trout trying to get close for a suicide, but no, he's just going to go for more right clicks. But Trout just goes for the immediate suicide to finish off Arteezy. And he's just laughing it off. And oh man, Arteezy's starting to tilt hard, boys. This is not good. Not good for the Dire's sake, that's for sure. Denied. Action has died down a bit, but those start to increase as Arteezy almost getting a kill onto Somali in the middle lane. He had one more point in Trout. He had a suicide up there, but Arteezy knows that. Should be down. And if that Dragon Slave actually hit Somali, then that would have spilled his death. And he knows exactly where his positioning is because of that Bloodseeker. His Dota is lagging a little bit. boots of that make can last it. Yeah, that's why I thought he got phase boots for in the meantime, but I wasn't too sure if he needed it. But TC finds himself a free kill onto I Annihilate, and that's another player that I didn't discuss that's in the game. TC has joined us for the first time tonight. Works on Team Liquid for a long time, now plays on Team Fire by X Mike and Company. Now Sumali almost getting a kill onto Arteezy. He's one more right click, but no, Trout is going to go from behind the tower and right clicks him down. Oh my goodness. And now Sumali does fall to one tower hit. Something along the lines of that.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
There was no hero damage done, so it was definitely the tower finishing off. Arteezy does get a nice bit of gold there. That's it, though. He did go opt for boots first rather than bottle. No, he didn't go phase before Soul Ring. There, Coltus. I remember he got Soul Ring as his first item, and then he got Blades of Attack. I remember talking about it. It was interesting. I was wondering, like, is he really going for phase boots? And I was trying to think, well, maybe he wants to just get in range of Suicide easier or that, but I guess he just doesn't want to use most of his mana just to farm, but I Annihilate and TC. TC's dominating this lane. 21 denies onto that base. Centaur only has 8 last hits. Miserable time up there. Fierce having himself quite a good time up here. Bloodrite is going to be used. Silences them both. And the chase is on. Not going to be able to find any kills, however. Fierce already has 5-minute blast. He's been farming pretty well. He leads the CS charts 5 minutes in, and looks like he actually missed the CS. Well, getting close to maybe one or two creeps. And Arteezy finds a solo kill onto Sumali in the mid lane. But that's the one thing about playing greedy. And the Sentry Ward is already there. So they know that there is a ward. Well, I mean, they will know that there are mines, excuse me, in the mid lane. Only PPD, all PPD has to do is not walk uphill. That's all he has to do. And there's even an observer ward right there that Trout put down. And they see it with this ward that PPD just placed. So very, very nice work coming in from PPD. And the support, it looks like there's some danger up here onto the top lane is just a little bit of engagement. Now they want to go back in. They do have the Balls of Wisp. It could go in onto Fear. That's exactly what they're going to do. Fear's taking a lot of damage, but Yawar blasted with the heal bomb coming from Dazzle. Now the Howl is going to go off in mid lane. Arteezy going to engage onto Sumali and finds the kill with the double damage rune. Just catching crit going down in the meantime. And top lane, Trout. He does have those phase boots. He does have suicide ready. And he does get the edge of Fear. You were able to finish him off. PPD finding. Is that a kill that. Okay, it was a kill that Lycan got.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Finding his momentum back. Finding two solo kills on the mid lane.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Probably better for his own sake, too. Tries to get a stun on Sumali, but able to dodge it. Now the 8-minute rune spawn,
Dire's
however, TC is going to meet Arteezy at the rune and just stun him. Nice job of a stun, and TC's static link is wasted. Now they're going to go engage onto top lane. Yawar's chain lane, the epicenter, but Fear is a fast wolf, and he can go kill. Very fragile to kill, and Yawar's going to try and TP. I'm not too sure about this, and they will find the kill onto the Sand King as well.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
So they use the epicenter while Fear was
Radiant's
in that ultimate form, and they find a very nice kill. Double kill, I mean, in fact.
Radiant structures
all they had to use was a wolf form and a rupture. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. As Xiao Fien as he does play,
has fallen.
Super squishy, especially to a hero with high burst like Lina. That's why you don't see mid SF usually anymore, because he's just so susceptible to ganks, and even if he's not susceptible to the ganks, he dies very easily to solo heroes. Beer still leading the charts in blast hits. Is this Shred online?
Dire's structures.
Once he gets that medallion, I feel like it's going to be Roshan time after that.
Dire's bottom tower
TC
has
does
fallen.
Get the tower kill. I Annihilate missed the stun. And they rotated three heroes bottom lane for that. I'm not sure if they TP'd, and ooh, I'm not sure if they saw that either. Dazzle did get smoked. It was envisioned. Not quite sure. I guess not. It's not being pinged out in Sumali. Uh-oh. Danger going down. Rupture. And, yep, dead.
Sanctioned by
Brit steals
honor.
That last hit. And Zai activates a haste rune, trying to be cheeky. Here goes those fate boots on Xiao. I discussed a little bit earlier. I guess it just varies. He definitely did go soloing first last game as Arteezy finds the kill onto Zai. Dragon Slave and that 1 point to Fiery Soul. Value point to Fiery Soul. Very nicely done. And now it's Roshan time. Nalian is online. They don't have anything vision-wise, but it is, oh, it is circled out.
Dire's bottom tower is
Trough
under
expects
attack.
It. They're heading around there right now. They're gonna do it just as they walk in. Trough, he does have a suicide. This could be deadly. All he has to do is place him down. Suicide, he kills off. He finishes off nobody, does bring him down to half HP, but here comes TC with a nice static link.
Bottom tower is under
Epicenter
attack.
Not even needed. And Trough calling out the smoke roach attempt. Very, very nicely done. PPD just says, oh, you guys are fine. There's no way, man. Arteezy will still die though. And just like that, 3 kills in a row for the Radiant squad. TC constantly checking out Roshan now. He does have a hand of Midas onto that Razor. That'll allow him to catch up a little bit and farm. And he's actually ahead of that Lycan, who has more last hits than him. Fear just retreats to the jungle. There are some mines there. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 mines. That could possibly kill him. Let me see. Yeah, count all the reduction and everything. That's gonna kill anyone that steps over them. Ralph being super sneaky with his techies. And made the correct call too. 13 to 11, we're averaging 2 kills a minute here. Game 6, at least for the cast of tonight in the NA Dota Elite League. We're in the holidays. There's no tournament matches going on, at least outside of Asia. Oh, Fear! Okay, so it wasn't enough. It brought him down to 25% HP though. 2 more mines and it would have done the job. Do remember, if you have high armor, then that reduces the mines damage because the mines damage are physical. Though fear gaining that early medallion probably might have saved him there. Plus the flats. You get 5 bonus armor and then you get 7 extra armor from the medallion. Very nice combo inside.
Has fallen.
Getting away with a small amount of HP. I'm not sure if they saw the relocate. No, they just decided not to bother with it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Annihilate's gonna get back just in time. Trough is back to his dirty work. One thing that I noticed about Trough build is that he doesn't get remote mind to level 6. Like most of the pub builds, same thing that he used. Shrine Retreat, RTZ is on a low amount of HP. Trout, he does have a suicide, but Blink Dagger just in time to dodge his suicide death. And now Tanky gonna go in. Fear is actually in the middle of the entire team. Nice Shallow Grave will save his life. And now RTZ just brits Zai. But Shadow Fiend finds the backstab kill on Fear with the Blink Dagger. I did not even expect that. PPZ is going to take a fall too. Double kill going the way of Sumali on that Shadow Fiend. Oh my goodness, where did that Shadow Fiend come from?
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Him and Razor are topping the net worth charts, and they're pulling away from Lycan.
Dire's middle tower
next one
is
up
under
above
attack.
That is Lina. Do quite as much damage with Golden. They're gonna find Trout placing mines. Nice double hero. Burrow Strike is gonna finish off I Annihilate. And now. Oh, RTZ. Does have a battle there, however. And they're gonna try and turn this around. They're gonna try and finish off Saiba. Nice ultimate coming from Sumali. Finishing off RTZ. He gets a triple kill, in fact, with his hero. And that's a Void Stone, so. Like Yul Scepter? Indeed. Yul Scepter Shadow Fiend is quite interesting. You send someone up into the air and you can ulti right on top of them. Max damage. It's also good for defensive purposes, which is what Shadow Fiend needs. That's why you see Mushy, players like Mushy, he builds mech on them first. Because you just can't do that anymore, and Sumali just sends crit up into the air and double raises him down. Not able to cast crit in time. TC almost done with the Aghanim Scepter, and that's 17 minutes in with the level 2 ultimate Aghanim Scepter. We'll have it within the next 10 seconds after this Midas. Yep, all he has to do is kill the creep, and we'll have the gold. War on the core Sand King. Buying himself a Blink Dagger, almost Force Staff. Die, not as much stuff. Alright, TZ was able to blink away, it seems. Caught that from my screen, but it was a little slow reaction from me. Die Annihilate, fine, lucky. And I do. And they timed it perfectly! RTZ going in on Zai. And Sumali going to be able to send him up into the air. And RTZ pays for his aggressiveness. BG well played indeed. As Sumali is going to blink himself forward, trying to find crit. And one more right click. Boom. Finishes him off. Wicked 6 streak, but they're gonna turn on to Sumali. And one swipe from PPD will allow Sumali to get a kill onto Centaur as he was dying. That's what it seems like, RTZ. Definitely what it seems like. 21 to 20. 41 kills in 18 minutes. We are averaging 2 kills, at least 2 kills a game, every single game tonight.
Radiant's top tower.
That's North American Dota for you, ladies and gentlemen. Scepter is completed now on TC. 1100 gold to boot. Most likely going to be a BKB next. Awesome to charge in there. Be able to man fight fear, especially. Those phase boots. I still love it. And this is what Trowfall also does. So, for those of you that want to know how to play techies, just follow what Trowfall does. He buys smokes with his heroes so that he can just, well, safely farm, in fact. I guess. Usually, what he does is he buys smokes and goes into an uncanny position and just places his mines like around top of wherever they might walk next. Tried to talk and then tried to find some action for more. He's gonna solo ulti onto Eye Annihilate, but gets bursted down by Arteezy. He was caught in the tree line, and TC is running in there with an ultimate himself, and now Sumali blinks away from danger. Seems fine. You don't want to go Yules on this set. Just purely going to. Oh, here comes the ulti, and oh my goodness, I annihilate. Got obliterated by that SF ulti there. My goodness. That hero damage was of all came from that ultimate. I mean, Centaur's a pretty squishy hero. If he doesn't get any stat items.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He certainly didn't. Sphere is now the next item for Shadow Fiend. So another defensive item. So we're not going to see him go for more of the right click. I have seen this before, and I was in fact a part of one of Sumali's games where he was just trolling around and Veil, he went for Dagon 5, he went for Yule Scepter. I don't think it's going to be one of these games though, because Trump was on the same team as us and he wasn't too pleased by that, to say the least.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
22 minutes in. Exactly 2 kills a minute.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Now TC is just free farming here onto the bottom lane. 3.1k gold. Hasn't spent it on anything as of yet. But as I said, BKB is an option as we see. Taken. First of down middle lane by TC. Getting close to that Aghanim Scepter.
Dire's bottom tower.
Ooh, almost
is under
in range
attack.
For that Yule Scepter. That ultimate was up from SF2, so Lena might have had the same fate. Our stampede's being used. Okay, I'm not sure what that one was quite for. See Sumali in the middle lane. Not gonna go after him though. Definitely thinks better of it. And Lincoln Sphere is completed now.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
What this does, it blocks off Rupture, it blocks off Lena's ultimate. Even have Poison Touch to be able to block
Radiant's
that.
Radiant's structures are fortified.
So it is a nice item this game, blocking two very nice spells attack. And fear. Oh, the Awar missed. And Sumali is getting engaged upon being sent up into the air, and now fear is gonna take a fall. Very nice relocate from Zai. I thought Sumali would get finished off. But no. Great relocate by Zai, saving his teammate. 23 minute Midas. Mr. Trowf. Not really sure what else you can get, because Techies is not a fast farmer in by any regards. Unless he like stacks up the jungle and then uses mines to finish it off. It's not gonna work. Now on this time, Arteezy's does hit and he does find Kral.
Dire's middle tower.
Not able to find anything else after that though, so they do find the techies, and once again, space being created. Sure thing. There's a Centaur Stampede, they use an ultimate. In the meantime, it gives his team freedom. Ward now has Yule Scepter and sends TTF into the air, and Yule Scepters are just being used everywhere. Freaking tornado storm coming going on out there.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
And now they're gonna re-engage as TC has a brand new shiny Shiva's Guard. Very nice blood rising gonna be used. Bloodseeker and TC is gonna get hauled down by Fear. And now Trowf dies immediately after TPing in. Does half damage to Fear. That's just about it though.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, that's a 3-0. 5k, that's 5k and 3.6k worth of experience. And now they know that they're roaching, but well, they can't stop it. Epicenter is up in 3 seconds and PPD. Oh my. There goes Sumali and Yawar. Oh, he walked in too close. But Zai, able to relocate in. He found the kill on Zephyr, and now Aya Nihilo will eat the brute with that Epicenter. But he's trying to get away from Sumali. We'll finish him off. Very nice blink. Yawar does die in the meantime. Fear fought back for that, so he has to get a Roche kill. Something has to happen to Arteezy. Finding the stun on Sumali. They're going on to Fear. And Fear has no ulti for him. He's not going to be able to get out of this. He does get graved up. But Sumali, blink dodges. Very nicely done, and Arteezy. Sayonara. Slip, splat, sploop. Arteezy does take a fall to Molly on a mega kill spree. Yeah. I'm getting a little bit exhausted, guys. I have been doing this for 6 hours straight. I need some food in me, that's what I'll need. So I'll probably take a break after this game and then come back with some more action later on tonight.
Roshan has fallen.
There has been some sloppiness.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Voice is sounding a little more tired as well. Can only take so much dude. I can only take so much hype.
Of course, that comes to practice.
He's bringing something on the courier. Okay, it's just the TP. I thought he already had something after that Shiva's Guard.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Yeah, Fear died back for that, and they didn't even get the Roshan. That fell into the hands of Sumali. 4.5k gold. And he's pinging like he wants to go in. He has an Aegis. His ulti is up soon. I have no idea what SF's next items are. Just so unpredictable. Arteezy does find the double kill. Oh, a solo kill, rather. But oh no, Fear! He gets destroyed by the Yule Scepter. He did a Yule Scepter ultimate. Oh man. Was not able to catch that. Zai will take a fall on the top lane.
Under attack.
They do get a 2-for-1, but those are practically two supports. And it did not show for Fear, but
Dire's middle tower.
Yeah, I appreciate all the support, guys, that y'all been giving me. You give me my biggest viewer count today. I think I was at 120 viewers at one point. So I want to thank you guys for that. Thank you for tuning in. As I do want to do more of this in the future, and well, any else helping me support my cause. And Crit activates the Grave in time, but he sets up into the air. Sumali's just toying around, and Arteezy not able to get the stun off, and Sumali is just going to right-click Arteezy down. Oh my goodness, and PPD now. He's also in danger of going down too. Somali's gonna blink forward. Nice double stun coming in from my Annihilate. But now, here comes the Blitz Relocate. Everyone's gonna be protected. Hive does get activated. And now Yamor does get a nice double hero stun onto Fear and I Annihilate. SF will come back alive soon. Is able to blink away though. Arteezy does get the stun onto him. Now follow up, yeah, lockdown. Fear gets the monster just free. Now, Fear gets the kill onto Techies as well. Wait, what? What in the world just happened? Huh? Yeah, I heard the suicide animation go off, but it looks like he suicided straight on top of one of Fear's Necronomicons. What? I'm confused. Is that really a thing? The courier died in the meantime. I didn't even see that go down. Oh well. Speaking of which, the map control that the Radiant have, they have two tier 1 towers online. And just the presence of Zai pushes Fear back, forces him to TP. Now has BKB. The Somali can't do the shenanigans that he's done to Fear before. Now I Annihilate, well, I'm not sure if that's a misclick, but now Watcher and Protector over this spot. For the time being. There we go. Blink down. Yep. Didn't have a gem up there or ward up there or anything. Simple misclick. Did see that pipe come into play, which is why I think the reason is why they won the last fight. War got a nice two hero epicenter with the Burrow Strike. And most of the damage got negated because of that pipe. Very nice choice coming from my Annihilate. It's TC Zion progression looking like. Weaver, so it looks like it's gonna be hard for the big man.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Armor. He is the Tin Man. Doing a nice job of scouting out with these wards, with these wolves, excuse me. Does he TC alone up there?
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, I did not know that. Zai, that takes a minute. He's able to find a tether target. But he did get... Oh, almost. Very nice relocate done by Zai. My goodness. This guy is such a player. I Annihilate finds a 2-0 stun. He does find Somali and Trow. He does send himself up into the air, but that's just delaying the inevitable. However, Yamor is going to come in. Stun in on Soratizi. Burrow Strike in Epicenter. I Annihilate is going to be safe, and Sphere gets a triple kill on the back end. Very nicely done. 4-0 wipe going the way of Dire. And that's a bigger XP change. Look at that. Jeez. 7.6k XP. That's almost 5k gold. I haven't taken a look at the gold graph or the XP graph in a while. That's definitely going to dip when it updates. Yeah, it's been slightly going the way of Dire for the past 10 minutes. The gold advantage certainly will go down, especially with these tier 1s being assaulted. Do they have a gem? Okay, they have one on PPD, so they are able to locate any mines that Trough has placed. So far, there are no landmines that are up. But, oh, Trough, oh boy. He is able to suicide himself, it's not a kill, but he's gonna sacrifice Zai's life as Arteezy comes in and just obliterates Zai. Yeah, that was a strange thing. When you commit suicide, you're supposed to be, you know, death by suicide, but maybe if you're new about that bug.
Is under attack.
I mean, Necronomicon is a core item to get on Lycan anyways, but something to think about.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
now
attack.
Now he's just solo pushing the tower. Let's activate the howl and let himself sit back as rest of his minions will deal the damage. Now he's gonna activate his ultimate.
Radiant's run the heck out of there. Has fallen.
Make sure his units get out of there as well. I have no idea who's winning this game. Radiant are now starting to lose map control very quickly. That gem being purchased by PPD. Gem has been a techie's counter in the past, and well, for an obvious reason. Arteezy just walks into a stasis trap.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Uh-oh, they see Arteezy. See him farming. Are they going to go for this? Yawar, oh, very nice blink. I'm not sure if that was intentional, but I would like to assume it is. So once Arteezy saw a Radiant hero, blink straight away. A fear. Bending his walls after Trowel.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
I annihilate. They did see him TP away, but just way too far from even from Blink Dagger 4 staff range.
Dire's top tower.
Do get a free
fallen.
Tier 2 tower in the top, so that's the last hour tower remaining for the Dire. I'm just gonna try and delay the push. Fear's pushing out that bottom lane. 5.2k gold now. I'm guessing he's just gonna save his golds until he has enough for buyback. Oh, he already has enough for buyback, but one more item plus buyback. I'm guessing his next item is going to be an AC. It has that BKB to deal with that magical damage. So it makes him so vulnerable too. I mean, before BKB, we saw Somali just sending him up into the air. Yule Scepter ulting out. Yep, and that is
Nacy
completed.
Fire.
That's also Trough going down once again. Though his presence has scaled downhill, especially ever since they got that gem. Now it is Roshan time. They are attempting it, but they see it with this ward. Not this ward, with this mine. Now Techies is buying back into the game. They do spot out Yawar on that Sand King.
Arteezy
with a refresher ward now. Oh my goodness, that is so scary. Double ulti and now Fear in danger. He's gonna activate BKB just for the last instant. Not doing any damage because all this damage is being snapped away by Razor, so he has to run away from that. Techies is gonna die for the second time. TC and Danger are going down. He's just delaying and a triple kill from Arteezy. And now Yawar is gonna take a fall as well. GG is gonna be the call out. The Somali, this kill did not work. He has the most net worth. Steve Trump's first Techies loss. Man, that refresher Lukuna, that Zai did not expect that at all. Now they have an Aegis. And it was a good run. Trough's Techies. Fortunately, it had to come to an end.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Very nice blink reaction from the Somali.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Just gets sent up into the air. Not much to worry about.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Here. Just gonna be sent back. Nice double boom stun coming out from my Annihilate. And it seals off Shadow Fiend and the Techies. Shadow Fiend. He does have buyback and he is gonna use it immediately. Io does take his spill. And Yawar, oh my goodness, the heal bomb is gonna come out. But the thing is about SF is he's not a great buyback hero. Is he does have enough. He does not have enough souls to deal the damage with his ulti.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
One of the biggest buyback heroes in the game. In terms of fighting immediately afterwards. And now Sumali gets a kill on the crit.
Radiant's
and that dazzle.
Tower has fallen.
Bursting him down. Annihilate trying to go in for another stun. TC is going to take the fall instead.
Dire's bottom
not quite yet.
Artesi,
he does have an
Radiant's
Aegis.
Bottom barracks are under attack.
Falls with the dieback to Artesi. Yep, that's going to be the end of this game. Very nicely done as Artesi gets sent into the fountain. Who did that four staff? That was Zaya, but
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Or is it getting hot in here?
I have no idea. I saw a four staff, I'm pretty sure. But it loses two lanes of racks. The GG did get
Radiant's
called.
Tower
it's just inevitable.
Tower.
Very nicely done by PPD. Oh, if you weren't activating the ultimate, PPD is going to lose the gem. That is a pretty big loss. They do have another one back at the base. Well, they have the option to get another one at least.
In the scintillant waste.
Burn, maybe burn.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Artesi's gonna look back in, try to find a kill onto Trout, almost getting it. Artesi's just getting Hurricane sent up into the air. But, oh, the stasis trap. Trap just got activated. A nice 3 hero stun though coming out from my Annihilate.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
He might pay with it with his own life. Artesi used buyback. This might not be good. Four staff uphill and side break him down. Oh, but here comes fear. Not gonna be able to chase though. Look at his illusions. Those look absolutely ridiculous. I can't imagine being on the other team seeing his illusions run that fast. Man, 52 and 37. This game certainly has not let up. Over 2 kills. At 41 minutes in, we're over 2 kills a minute. These are the games I like to cast. And I'm grateful to be bringing this action to you guys as well. Well, Fear, Sacred Relic, that's gonna be... Fear is not the type of person to go Rapier. There is still a chance where the Radiants come back. Artesi doesn't have any buyback and he has to be careful. The Radiant kill him off again. And they kill Fear. Fear has no buyback, in fact he doesn't even have a TP. He has to run his way back there. Tier 3 is being assaulted right now. Fear, get your ass back to base, sir.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Probably wants to wait until Artesi is up.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
But yeah, they're just gonna give away a rack for free.
Middle barracks are under attack. Dire's middle barracks
and Yawar forced out himself forward. Does find initiation to surround the PPD, but that is a big mistake. Now Fear is just gonna man fight the entire team. He already finishes off Sumali. And Zai is gonna relocate themselves back.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And Blink Tagger away. Oh, will he be able to get away? Yes, he will. Very nicely done by Zai. Shift Q that Blink Dagger. Have buyback? No. Oh, Smalley just purchased the Daedalus, so he doesn't have buyback. This is the end. I believe this is the end. Like semi-sonic, exploding time for them. Trout just gets blasted by Arteezy, but he does commit suicide, so it does let him lose one time. Arteezy, here we go. Fear is just mauling him down, finishing him off. He buys back into the game. I Annihilate is just being a distraction, trying to draw attention away from them, engaging them off the throne, and TC is gonna suffer a dieback, but now Yamora's gonna bring Bro Strike Epicenter. That's not gonna be enough in TNR. TZ blinks away from all the action, and that will be GG. The game is sealed. And Arteezy, surprisingly at the bottom of the NEL ladder, finds himself a win in this game. Man, great game coming out from both teams. That won't quite